Are you someone who is wasting a lot of time every day and you feel very lazy the whole day and you're working from home and you're switching between the tasks and spending a lot of time on YouTube or maybe all the distractions and you really want to learn the three powerful secrets that helps you can get more done every day? As a lazy person, I can also understand because I used to be like you. Where, you know, I wake up with a WhatsApp and I sleep with a YouTube. I spend a lot of time on Instagram before 3 years back. Yes, I used to be a junkie and I overconsume the content. But now the completely changed. I completely changed my routine into a super productive routine. And not only that, I am becoming the whole day productive, right? In this video, I go deep into about the three best productivity secrets that helps lazy people can get more done every day. I'm going to tell you the three simple secrets, you know, very simple in the sense, even you can do it, even though irrespective of whether you wasted the last year or not. But whatever you are about to learn will be immediately implemented. Along with that, you can also get results immediately. Using the same productivity, I'm able to build two careers at the same time. One is my software job. Along with that, I'm building a six-figure business online at the same time. You know, how is it possible as a lazy person, as a procrastinator? I'm an expert in procrastination. I used to procrastinate a lot. I had a lot of things to do. You know, in my college days, I used to be a leader where a lot of burden on me and a lot of tasks should be done. But still, I'm procrastinating on my smartphone, on my laptop, playing games. You know, watching a lot of unnecessary videos, right? At that time, my results were completely zero. And at the end of the day, I felt a lot of regrets. I felt a lot of distractions and my motivation has been reduced in such a way that at the end of the day, no satisfaction. Even I wake up again, you know, the loop, the more you waste time, the more you are about to waste the time. That is what in the loop of negative habit of wasting a lot of time. Then one day I decided, Ramesh, we should come out of this loop. We should kill this bad habits and become super productive. You know, in the journey, I went through hundreds of frameworks, a lot of mentors, trainings, coachings. You know, I experimented 100 plus routines, read more than 90 plus books. You know, I have coached more than 1,000 plus people so far. The interesting thing I found is it's very easy to become productive. Yes. In this video, I go deep into about the three secrets. Just remove all of your distractions, come closer, just grab your notepad and pen if possible, or even you can take digital notes so that I'm going to tell you the three secrets that will change your life, right? Secret number one, use your distractions as rewards. You know, in this world, in this 2021, we have a lot of distractions, yes or no? And distractions are one click away. Like short videos, like Instagram reels, like YouTube, like WhatsApp, like all the negative junk, you know, Amazon Prime, IPL, these kind of things, right? But if you treat the way you perceive them will raise your productivity. You know, if you treat them as an entertainment, yes, of course, those are entertainment. But if you treat them as a distractions, that will definitely won't serve you. But if you treat them as a rewards, I mean, suppose for your kid, suppose if you give some chocolate to a kid, he will be very happy. Suppose if you tell them, if you finish the homework, then I'll give you the chocolate. He feels very awesome and he go to his room and finish all the homework and he come up with the chocolate. You know, chocolate is a reward for the work he has done. In the same way, we also love rewards, including you're a student or an entrepreneur or an employee. You know, you love rewards, yes or no? We literally enjoying the rewards. So whenever you are about to consume some entertainment, whenever you are enjoying the distraction, please enjoy it. But from this momentum, ask this question. Am I really deserve this? Am I really creating value to the world? You know, the deserving mindset is literally plays a key role. If you have that deserving mindset, that will give you more power. You know, even after recording this video, I take 10 minutes of YouTube. Maybe I can watch training videos. I can watch maybe some comedy videos because I believe for recording this kind of powerful content, I take YouTube as a reward. So am I deserving that reward? Of course, yes, because I put, you know, 4 hours the effort to create this kind of records and, you know, editing the stuff and publishing it. Can you see this? From next time on, you have to use your distractions as a reverse. Like, suppose whenever you're about to listen music or whenever you're about to watch Amazon Prime web series or Netflix, right? Do some work and get some reward. That is what the intention of it. It's very simple. Suppose you're about to spend half an hour in Amazon Prime, do some half an hour work, do your important work. I know you have goals. I know you know how to do it. And I know your plan. You're already planned, equipped with the plan. But the issue is, the problem is, you don't know how to execute it, right? That is where I'm giving you the weapon. The weapon name is use distractions as reward. Make sure you do some work and feel that, oh my God, I did this work. Now I enjoy this reward, right? I enjoy this reward, then bundle together. That is called temptation bundling. Inside our community, we follow a rule called 80-20 rule. 20% we consume the content, then 80% we take action. For example, suppose if my community member, if my student or me watches a video of 20 minutes, then we should go and take action of 80 minutes. Got it? Type "got it" in the comment box. It's all about a Pareto principle. It's not about consuming the content. It's not about over entertaining yourself. It's all about creating some value to the world, raising your level to the next level, and be confident and leave this life with some legacy. That's what I always believe in. From next time on, whenever you are enjoying yourself, make sure you deserve that. Make sure you deserve that. Secret number two, choose the work which is challenging. You know what it means? Choose the work which is challenging. In most of the cases, in the whole day, you are more likely to spend on your smartphone. You know, according to a research recently done last year, more than 7.5 hours we spent on smartphone. Yes, more than 7.5 hours we spent on smartphone, which is completely a distraction. And one important thing is, after waking up, within 15 minutes, we are more likely to open smartphone and we are more likely to open WhatsApp or whatever the case is. It may be news channels, it may be Facebook, some random stuff. Yes or no? Right? From next time on, you know, whenever you are about to do some work, you know you are doing it, you need to do it, but you choose the work which is challenging. What it means is, if you choose a complex activity, you cannot do it, because your mind won't likely to do it. You will procrastinate. Suppose you're a fourth class kid. What if I give you an algorithm to develop? Maybe I can give you a program which is very complex to you. Would you do it? Definitely no, because your skill level is not matching with work capability, right? You have that talent in your mind, but if you are being overburdened with yourself, you will procrastinate. Because I went deep into the psychology and neurology of the human mind. If you take a difficult task, you procrastinate. Yes or no? How many times you set goals, you plan your day, you decided to do it. When you start some work, within few minutes, you lost the momentum, you go to the distraction. You know why? The biggest reason is you have taken a biggest difficult task. That is a problem. Whenever, suppose your skill capability is here, the difficulty of the task is here, there is no match, right? In those cases, you procrastinate. And there is an inverse way to this. Suppose if you take the work which is very easy, you feel very bored. You feel very bored. For example, there is a programmer in Google developer. For Google developer, if I give you a small program called maybe sum of two numbers or maybe multiplication of two numbers, he feels bored, you know, because he already built a powerful algorithms. Just a small program with a one line, it's very simple to him. In the same way, if you take suppose your capability is this, but you take the small work to do, you feel bored and you again jump into the distraction, because your distractions are more attractive than your current work. Yes or no? So both are wrong. Your capability high and your work taken is low, or your work is very difficult and your capability is low, both won't work. From next time on, whenever you are wasting a lot of time in your day, whenever you are jumping between the apps to apps, whenever you are wasting a lot of time on social media and random things, you choose a task. It's in your ability to choose a simple task, and that should not be overcomplicated. That should not be very easy to you. You should match your skill level with the work capability, match it together so that you are more likely to do the activity. Secret number three, chunk the work into as simple as possible. you know why, in most of the cases, why we procrastinate? Because you felt, oh my God, it's very hard, I can't do it. This kind of negative thoughts, negative intuitions you will get because you had a previous experience that you tried and you failed. You know why you joined the gym and you paid thousands and thousands for the gym subscription. In just 1 week, you lost the momentum and you come back and you are jumping into the old habits. You know the reason? Because you are not implementing this chopping concept, chunking the work into as simple as possible. You know, whenever you are procrastinating, whenever you are wasting a lot of time, if you're a student, imagine if you're a student, suppose you are about to go for an exam. You know exam, you need to get some mark, you need to read some chapters, subjects. In the chapter, divide it into concept, divide it into page. You can start with a paragraph. You know, if you start with a one minute activity, you know, the interesting thing is 1 minute work and 30 minute break. Yes. It is not strange. I implemented a lot of times on my life. Whenever I'm procrastinating to shoot a video or whenever I'm procrastinating to learn some complex activities like Facebook ads, retargeting, or maybe, you know, solving big problems, I do this. Chopping my work into small pieces as possible. I do 1 minute of work and I take 30 minutes of break. I start the work. Okay. I will read this one page. It takes 1 minute. So I read it and then I go for YouTube. I spend 30 minutes on YouTube with a timer. Then I come back and I read the second page. You know how it works? Whenever you are doing some work, 1 minute, 30 minutes break, 1 minute, 30 minutes break. Within 3 to 4 cycles, you found that 1 minute take 2 minutes. You go a little bit prolonged. You literally increasing your time of your work. Slowly, 1 minute become 2 minutes. 2 minutes become 4, 8, 16, 32. You know, slowly you are increasing it. Even if you increasing your work time, make sure you're decreasing your reward time, which is 1 minute work, 30 minutes break to 5 minutes work and 25 minutes break. Slowly within 5-6 cycles, 10 minutes work and 20 minutes break. You know what I'm telling is there are two parts. Your work is very little and your reward system is very high. Make sure you are increasing your work and reducing your reward, increasing the work, reducing the reward, increasing the work and reducing the reward. In such a way that what happens is you are more likely to create a routine on your mind that will make you addicted positively towards your work. Yes, it is possible. While chopping it, make sure you chop into the basic. Suppose if you chop into a complex activity, suppose one activity depends on other. And if you cannot do this activity, you cannot go this activity. Suppose if you pick the complex or maybe very advanced topic or any concept, It's impossible, right? You again procrastinated. Suppose you're an employee. You have a deadline to finish. You have to submit some project to your manager. You have a lot of work to do and you know the plan, you know how to execute it, but still you are procrastinating. In those cases, what you have to do? Chopping into a very simple concept, simple activities. Take one basic number one activity, right? If you take the 20th activity, again, you procrastinate. Take the basic activity and finish it in 1 minute. I know it's impossible to finish any activity in 1 minute, but it's in your ability to cut that activities into a small units as possible. You can go even 1 minute or even you can go 30 seconds. You know, in my life, I used to procrastinate on shooting videos because I was completely a shy person and I have that inferiority complex in my life. So I cannot able to go forward and speak in front of people, but I wanted to kill that feeling. I wanted to come out of that feeling. Whenever I thought of recording a video, I procrastinate. I procrastinate a lot. You know, I set up everything, but again, there is a little voice on my mind. Ramesh, you can't do this. Ramesh, you are not for this. Ramesh, this is not for you. This kind of words are keep on telling me. Then I understand. Then I implemented this chopping example. Okay, Ramesh, that's fine. Now, if you shoot a 30 seconds video, just 30 seconds, shoot a 30 seconds video, take 30 minutes break. It might strange, but actually it's working like a magic to me and to my students, just for you as well. 30 seconds, I shoot a video in the form of selfie camera, selfie video. Then I posted it on my WhatsApp groups. You know, I have a WhatsApp group who have the people who encourages me. Because before I start recording this 30 seconds videos, I created a WhatsApp group, some name on it, like Shyness to Awesomeness. And just adding my close friends who literally loves my success, you know, don't add negative people. Add the people who literally encourages you. Then I tell them, every day I give you 30 seconds video. Just watch it. It's not about content. It's not about background. It's not about music. It's about I'm showing up or not. Yes. If I'm showing up but every day, then they will applaud me. They will love the content. They're giving me the feedback. And slowly, 30 second video on 30 minutes break seems strange to everyone. But I believed in that. I believed in that and start recording it. And 30 seconds, slowly after 3 or 4 cycles, you know, while talking and I even forget about shyness, I'm recording, you know, 40 seconds, 50 seconds on 1 minute videos. And I feel, you know, I can see small improvement coming in, a small progress, you know. Progress inspires you, not the result. Results never inspires you. Progress inspires you. Even I found in a hard way that people love progress. Yes. So 1 minute video, 30 minutes break. 1 minute video, 30 minutes break. Then I found that, okay, slowly 1 minute to 2 minutes. Slowly, you know, subconsciously I'm increasing. I don't even consciously set a timer for 1 minute so that I can go for a break. No, I'm preparing some concept and I visualized it on my mind and I'm opening the camera and just talking it. You know what I found? 1 minute become 2 minutes, 2 minutes become 4 minutes, 5 minutes. Even now, I'm able to shoot a video which goes beyond 3 to 4 hours. Even I do long sessions with my community where 3 to 4 hours I'm talking without any breaks, without any hesitations or preparation. You know, how is it possible? Because of I chopped my work into as simple as possible and I, you know, be so good so that you can't ignore you, right? Be so good so that you can't ignore it. That is what the principle involved into this chopping concept. Make sure you can watch the videos inside my YouTube channel. Maybe you can watch other videos. You can see the length of the videos. It's always greater than 10 minutes, 10, 20, 30, 40, even 50 minutes videos also there. You know, how is it possible? Because of this chopping concept. From next time on, whenever you procrastinate a lot, whenever you feel you're literally not interested to do, just remember this concept. You need to chop the work into as simple as possible. Even you can chop 30 seconds. 30 seconds is possible. Never ever underestimate these 30 seconds. Here, it's not about the 30 seconds. It's about you are showing up and doing some work and create some routine on your mind. Slowly, you are creating a routine on your mind and you are more likely to get addicted to the work and you are more likely to finish it. There is no magic, right? I hope you really enjoyed this video. Now, if you're really serious and want to learn more and really ready to become very productive, and I'm very excited and personally invite you to my next brand new super productive bootcamp. It's a powerful 4 live session bootcamp. It's a weekend bootcamp where I go deep into about these concepts. Along with that, I will show you with the even more existing powerful examples and templates. I'm going to give you a template you can take home, like Focus Like Monk template, 100% consistency tracker template. I'm going to give you an accountability tracker template. I'm going to give you a template after the bootcamp you can take home and you can implement it on your life based on the work you have to finish. Yes, I don't believe in visualization and goal setting. I believe in putting myself in and take action. Then only we'll get results. I always believe in that. If you're an employee, if you're an entrepreneur or a student or anyone who has big dreams in your life, who always set goals, plan the day, but not able to execute it, this is the right place. Click the link below. You can jump into the landing page where you fill all the details and jump into it, where you'll be redirected to a WhatsApp group, secret WhatsApp group, where the training will take place. If you really want a serious guidance from me, just come to my next Super Productive Bootcamp. And before we finish this video, can you hit the like button and subscribe to this channel? Because this is my brand new channel on YouTube where I will add powerful content like this every single week, maybe 2 to 3 times per week. Along with that, hit the bell icon so that you'll be notified. Now, finally, can you type what is your number one takeaway in the comment box? If you type that in the comment box, I will respond to you with some awesome comments, right? Thank you for watching. See you inside my bootcamp. This is Ramesh Yadav, Productivity Expert, signing off.